Karman Plus is a space startup based in Denver that has ambitions to build autonomous satellites that can mine asteroids for useful materials. Recently, the company raised $20 million in financing to help build hardware and software for their first asteroid mission. Initially, the company will focus on extracting water from asteroids, a resource that could power their space tugs tasked with transporting materials back to low Earth orbit. Some satellites and space tugs use water for propulsion, so this asteroid-derived water can provide an early revenue stream by providing life extension services to aging satellites. Beyond propulsion, water serves as an excellent radiation shield, and with sufficient purification, could even be sold as drinkable water for commercial space stations. Looking ahead, Karman Plus plans to tap into rare earth metals and other high-value materials locked within asteroids. What might sound like science fiction is, according to their team, a profitable idea that's closer to reality than most people realize. Initially, they aim to keep costs low, under $10 million per mission, by using off-the-shelf components paired with autonomous technology. However, by 2024, their strategy shifted. They now produce 80% of their components in-house, outsourcing just 20%. This move towards vertical integration has cut both time and costs. Interestingly, they're not alone in this pivot. Astroforge, a rival asteroid mining company I've covered before, also swapped out their off-the-shelf parts for in-house production to streamline operations. The potential market for refueling existing satellites is worth $4 billion per year by 2030, according to Karman Plus's calculations. The company's name, Karman Plus, is a nod to the Karman line, the boundary 100 kilometers or 62 miles above Earth's surface where space officially begins. The plus signifies their ambition to go beyond, a fitting name for a team aiming to unlock the riches of asteroids. Mining asteroids. Karman Plus sees asteroid mining as a gold mine, figuratively and maybe literally. While fields like quantum computing and nuclear fusion, still unprofitable but full of potential, attract swarms of startups and billions in funding, asteroid mining remains underinvested. The company believes asteroid mining could be a flywheel that starts the entire off-Earth economy. Think about it. Water could be extracted for drinking, converted into rocket fuel, or used as radiation shielding. Industrial metals like iron and nickel could fuel construction in low Earth orbit, while rare Earth minerals and precious metals like gold and platinum could be shipped back to Earth for profit. Asteroids contain more materials than humanity has mined in its entire history, and it's just floating out there in space. What's more, asteroids can provide higher yields than Earth's depleted mines. On our planet, many mines are running dry, demanding more time and money for dwindling returns. Meanwhile, global consumption of copper, silver, platinum, and rare earth metals keeps climbing with no end in sight. New sources are urgently needed to avoid a supply crunch, and asteroids might just be the answer. Certain types of asteroids, specifically metal-type asteroids, contain metals at higher yields than can be found on Earth. Industrial metals like iron and nickel, and precious metals such as gold and platinum, will likely provide profitable amounts of these materials, assuming the technology to mine and extract can be developed. In terms of yields, my research suggests asteroids can provide much higher yields for industrial metals such as iron and nickel. On Earth, mining iron results in iron oxides forming at the surface, reducing yields. In space, where there is no oxygen, pure iron and nickel can be mined, resulting in much higher yields than Earth. For gold, it's not so clear-cut. Gold appears to be in the range of 1 to 2 grams per ton in metal-type asteroids, comparable to low-grade Earth mines. Still, for asteroid mining, you are likely mining various different metals and materials at the same time. For instance, the asteroid 16 Psyche that NASA is sending a probe to is thought to be 30 to 60% metal and could yield up to 50% pure metal. We'll find out in 2029 when the NASA probe arrives. To get an idea of how valuable some asteroids are, mining and extracting metals from Psyche and selling them on Earth at today's market prices would net you $100,000 quadrillion. That's just for mining iron alone. This company is very transparent and have laid out their plans in detail, so let's check them out. Karman's master plan. The plan is to off-world polluting industries like mining and put them into space. That means heavy industries can be moved into space where they can benefit from plenty of energy from the sun and unlimited space, pun intended. That requires a supply chain of billions of tons of material in orbit at a scale and cost that isn't possible yet. Karman has broken down the task into a number of distinct phases that each use a different architecture, approach, and levels of funding needed. By building up capabilities from one phase to the next, they can gradually develop all the technologies needed to mine and extract billions of tons of asteroidal material, returning it to low Earth orbit for consumption. The company has identified some key areas that they need to be great at. Here is the list. 1. Deep space asteroid missions. They are thinking autonomous, low cost, and reliable. 2. Mining in zero G. Excavating asteroid material safely and at scale. And 3. Processing and refining asteroid material into useful resources. In a nutshell, those are the key requirements. Many other requirements are needed, such as space logistics, last mile delivery for refueling, orbital processing, and space-based solar power, but there's no need to master those technologies at the beginning. Okay, let's get on to the phases Karman Plus has identified in their master plan. Phase 0, exploration. The company explored whether it is the right time to get into asteroid mining. Is there a market for resources extracted from asteroids? They came to the conclusion that there is a market for in-space resources and that a private company with limited capital can exploit this market and can be profitable. Asteroids are more abundant and easier to get to than other resources, such as the moon, for example. The market to refuel satellites in low Earth orbit is likely billions, increasing to over $4 billion by 2030, according to Karman's estimates. The moon remains difficult to reach and is at the bottom of a gravity well. Phase 1, touch and go. Their first missions will be touch and go missions. These are individual missions with a relatively small spacecraft that's less than 1,000 kilos in mass. The objective will be to extract water from an asteroid to fuel the spacecraft. They expect to return useful material back to low Earth orbit, likely to an orbiting fuel depot. They are not doing last mile delivery to individual satellites yet. Missions will cost $20 million at first, reducing to a low end of $10 million later. Optimized costs will be in the range of $10,000 per kilo, which is broadly in line with current costs, which are around $6,000 to $12,000 per kilo. For satellites in geostationary orbits, the cost of sending mass to these orbits is multiple times higher, so refueling from in-space resources would be cheaper. Karman thinks the initial resources offered for sale would be water, oxygen, and hydrogen for fuel and life support. To move on to the next stage, the company would need to successfully manufacture thruster fuel from processed asteroid material. By manufacturing fuel for the return journey from the asteroid back to Earth orbit, they can break out of the need to carry all the fuel needed to and from the asteroid when launching. Phase 2, mine and tug. This phase involves installing a mine permanently on the asteroid. This mine includes a processing plant to build space tugs that return sorted or semi-processed materials back to Earth's orbit. The mine continuously excavates and processes materials from the asteroid, filling up tugs that are regularly returned to Earth orbit. These tugs are a combination of small components brought from Earth, such as thrusters, navigation systems, combined with components made on the asteroid, such as structures, fuel, and solar panels. Mass return to Earth would range from tens of tons to thousands of tons per mission, with each mission costing $100 to $150 million. When optimized to the lower end of $100 million, these costs of return resources will be competitive with resources lifted from the Earth's surface. The breakthrough needed to move on to the next phase is to create more advanced components on the asteroid. Phase 3, use a hull buffalo. In this phase, the whole asteroid is exploited. The idea is that the asteroid would be captured and moved to a more convenient location for processing, such as near the moon or Lagrange points. Mass return to Earth's orbit will be millions of tons per mission. Given the larger scale and complexity of these missions, each mission is likely to cost between $500 million to $1 billion. The cost of produced resources will be approximately 1 cent per kilo when optimized. In this phase, it will be possible to build space-based solar power plants or O'Neill cylinders as colonies or cities in space. Majority of heavy industries can be moved off Earth, as well as energy production, to reduce pollution and environmental stress from Earth, leaving only light industries on Earth. Phase 4, the Expanse. Moving away from Earth, the Expanse phase moves from Earth-centric operations to prospecting for resources in the main asteroid belt to build a sustainable base of operations. This would involve a mixture of phases 2 and 3 from an architectural perspective, but looking at a fully self-sustaining ecosystem in between Mars and Jupiter. Timeline for all of this? Decades for certain, but it shows you how ambitious Karman is. Okay, let's move on to their first planned mission. High Frontier Mission. Their primary mission objective is to rendezvous with an uncharacterized near-Earth asteroid and demonstrate capturing asteroid material at kilogram scale, minimizing mission duration and cost. They have a flight booked for February 2027. After a rideshare launch and an autonomous deep space cruise, the spacecraft will rendezvous with the target asteroid, scan the asteroid for minerals, and start excavating material. The company is preparing a second mission at the end of 2027 with a customer interested in life extension for their existing spacecraft, which will use the same design and architecture. Asteroid missions in the past sample a few grams of materials on an asteroid. Karman Plus wants to excavate at the kilogram scale. A kilogram is 1,000 grams, using a touch-and-go method. Retrieving large amounts of material from an asteroid for refining and extraction is a key requirement for asteroid mining. So this mission will demonstrate retrieving materials at 1,000 times the rate of a scientific asteroid mission. This is the primary goal of the mission. To use their capital received from investors as efficiently as possible, the mission will rely on autonomous operations for in-flight operations. This enables the company to scale through software and algorithms rather than needing more people monitoring satellites to and from asteroids. In addition, the mission will analyze the extracted material using sensors to understand its composition. This will help inform the company on reserves of materials for the asteroid, helping them to decide if it's profitable to mine and extract based on expected yields. This is no different from Earth, where a potential mining area is drilled for samples and analyzed before deciding to go ahead and establish a mine. Initially, Karman Plus is looking for the percentage of water that can be extracted from the asteroid material. Using a number of tags, that's touch-and-go descents, on different parts of the asteroid, they will assess the highest yielding location for mining and extraction. Upcoming events. Their first mission, called High Frontier, will launch on SpaceX's Transporter 19 in February 2027. The company hasn't decided on the target yet, and will leave that decision until the last moment. They aim with the mission to demonstrate the company's ability to fly in space, rendezvous with an asteroid, and mine approximately 1 kilo, that's 2 pounds, of material. The early business model will extract water from an asteroid, followed by a second mission to refuel an aging but valuable satellite for a paying customer. They plan 4 missions in 2028 and 8 in 2029, with the eventual goal of offering in-space servicing, refueling, and the potential sale of high-value space resources back on Earth. Van der Dries, a co-founder of Karman Plus, said, "There's an initial market that we think will require at least tens of these spacecraft working concurrently. If we can refuel our customers, we can also refuel ourselves, and that allows for reusability in orbit. It's not something that at this stage we're assuming will work immediately, but clearly a goal in terms of scaling for the long term," unquote. Karman Plus is not the only asteroid mining company. Astroforge is another asteroid mining company I've reported on. In fact, their second mission is due to fly today on the IM-2 mission. Check out my video to learn more about this rival asteroid mining company. How realistic do you think asteroid mining is? Let me know in the comments section below. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.